Hey there, Spark fans, Rob Reynolds here. For almost a decade now, hobbyists and makers have had the tools to add Wi-Fi connectivity to their projects thanks to advances from companies like Espressif. From the original ESP8266 and the more robust ESP32, the Internet of Things boom simply couldn't have happened without affordable and accessible Wi-Fi modules. However, security concerns have always been an issue. Well, Espressif has addressed those concerns by releasing a brand new module, and we are pleased to be able to bring it to you on a new board and a familiar footprint. Introducing the new SparkFun ThingPlus ESP32-S2 WROOM. Now, this thing has a spec sheet about as long as a CVS receipt, so get comfortable and let's take a look and see what it's got. This latest incarnation in our ThingPlus line boasts Espressif's ESP32-S2 WROOM module, a 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi System-on-Chip. Now, this module addresses the security flaws in the original ESP8266 and ESP32 with an extensive list of features, including anti-power glitching circuitry to prevent hacks against secure boot and flash encryption. The extensive single-core 32-bit LX7 microprocessor is capable of speeds up to 240 MHz. It has a RISC-V ULP coprocessor, 128K of ROM and 320K of SRAM, and 4 MB of embedded SPI flash storage. There are multiple cryptographic hardware accelerators, including AES, ECB, CBC, OFB, CBF, CTR, GCM, SHA, RSA, and ECC. For physical security, the ESP32 uses transparent external flash and RAM encryption with AES XTS. A secure boot feature ensures only signed firmware with RSA PSS signature is booted. HMAC and Digital Signature modules use software inaccessible keys to generate SHA-MAC and MAC signatures. It also has an integrated 802.11 BGN Wi-Fi 2.4 GHz transceiver and an integrated temperature sensor. It operates within a voltage range of 3.0 to 3.6 volts DC and draws a peak of 310 milliamps while using Wi-Fi, 552 microamps in light sleep, and between 20 and 235 microamps in deep sleep. You'd think that would be enough. However, there are also some features that are unique to our ThingPlus board. Features like native USB and UART bridge ICs, selectable via three-way jumper. There's also multiple charge current options, either 100 or 500 milliamps, also jumper selectable. And what about all the remaining GPIO pins from this module that aren't usually accessible via the standard feather footprint? Well, we've broken all of those out to SMD pins on the back of the board. That's right, you've got access to 100% of the GPIO pins from this module. Now, unlike many other ESP modules, this one does not have BLE. However, if your Wi-Fi project demands Bluetooth connectivity, it's going to be much easier for you to add a Bluetooth module than to add a patch internet security vulnerabilities module. And while having someone hack your project and play with your smart light bulbs may seem like little more than an inconvenience, that might also give them access to your Wi-Fi credentials and access to every connected device in your home. And with DIY Wi-Fi projects becoming more complex and popular, keeping these projects safe from prying eyes and hacking hands becomes much more important. So keep your Wi-Fi project secure with the new SparkFun ThingPlus ESP32-S2 WROOM. Pick up yours over at sparkfun.com, and as always, stay safe, be kind, and happy hacking. Have to put some dancing hot dogs in there or something to keep people interested. Back in the bunker, my undisclosed location, somewhere deep under a mountaintop in the Himalayas. Put a monkey on a bicycle go in front of my face or something to make it interesting. Huh, that actually went better than I thought. I think it's okay. I'm gonna go back and look at it.